Shalom from Israel. This Shabbat we read Parashat Shoftim. Well, till now it seems that reading the Torah gives you only a way how to treat your own personal life or maximum your family. But this Shabbat we understand that it's not enough. The Torah wants to guide us how to build a nation. A nation. Well, this is the nation of Israel. And of course, all the nations can learn from the instructions of the Torah how to build the society. So first thing is that you need a judge. Judges that will judge according to the justice. But it's not enough. You need police. Because if the judge say something and it won't happen, so we know how the reality is. You need a system that will make sure that the judge will be the right one. And second, that everything they say at the end will happen. And what about the king? How the Torah wants us to build a kingdom? Should it be a king? Should it be a democracy like today? So it's interesting. The Torah says, it doesn't really matter. When you enter into the land, and you say that you want a king like all the nations, then you can have a king. So when you read this scripture, you understand that the Torah doesn't really care if it's a king or it's a different system. The main issue is that people will be good, and if you want that it will be like the nations, those times, kingdom, it's okay. But I want to tell you, Mel Moshe, what the king needs to do that won't happen to him, what happened to all other kings. Well, first he needs to make sure that he will not have too much women. And second, not too much money. And third, he needs to learn Torah a lot. He will have a special Sefer Torah and he will learn it day by day. And third, not too much horses, not to show his proudness. Why? Because the main issue is, this is what the Torah really cares, how is the people, of course, and how is the leaders? This is the main issue. So, it might be a king, or it might be a prime minister. It's okay. The Torah doesn't really give you an order that it should be a king. It can be something close to a king, like democracy, like prime minister. It's all the same. But the main issue is, how is the people? Exactly with the judges. Of course you need judges. Every society built with a trial. Even in Sdom they had judges. But in Sdom, they judged the people like the Nazis. Also the Nazis, they had a law, and when we captured, the Americans captured the Nazis, and they told how they did such evil things, well, most of them said, that was the law. We worked according to the law. So this is not what the Torah really cares, that we will build a system. Every society built a system of judges and a kingdom and a police. This is not the issue. But the Torah really care who will sit on the chair of the judges. Those who you cannot bribe them. Those who understand that they are sitting on the seats of Hashem and they obey the good rules of Hashem. And also the king. The main issue with the king, that he will be full of proudness, that he is the king. So the Torah teaches us, make sure that this one who is now at the top, He doesn't think about himself. He's a humble man. Like David HaMelech. David HaMelech, when he was a king, he knew how to rule. But when his son Avshalom threw him from the kingdom and he had to run away to the east, and Shimei ben Gera came and cursed him, he said to his people, "Don't harm, don't do anything to him, because I'm not the king now. Now I'm David HaMelech. When I am the king, it's different. If someone hit the king, he hits Hashem. If he curses, he has to be punished. This is something else. But it's not my ego. This is the issue. How to build a king that it's not coming from his ego. So, of course, we pray every Shabbat that Hashem will give wisdom to our leaders. And we hope that our leaders are not working. Their ambition is not from their ego. And the best thing to do it is to read again and again the Torah that teaches you that you are here just a soldier of Hashem, no matter who you are, even if you are the prime minister or the president of USA. Shalom from Israel.